as weather patterns continue to become unpredictable due to climate change and global concerns rise over food security, some farmers have embraced innovative ways of growing crops and getting high yields throughout the year without having to depend on the rain seasons. Hydroponics, which is an urban farming method, is offering those with small spaces an alternative way to grow fruits, herbs, and vegetables throughout the year for home consumption and sale to generate an income. Today on the Harvest Money Show, we are featuring Godfrey Kiyoko, who is an hydroponics expert. He shares how hydroponics can be a solution to the limited space for farming and also a solution to increasing food shortage. Hello, thank you for watching Urban TV tonight with me, Jackie Acha. Let me welcome you back from the Harvest Money Expo that happened. That was on Friday until Sunday. And we had so many people turn up for the expo, learn about agriculture. We want to know if it is possible for most of us who live in urban dwellings, if it's possible to farm, make money for yourself out of farming, and also have something to eat out of farming, perhaps in your area, in your small space within the city, because urban farming is all about, as I understand, farming within that small space you have within your dwelling in the city. And with me tonight is Godfrey Kiyoko. He's an expert, so we'll have to hear from him what he has to say. So welcome, Godfrey. I want to hear everything, as everybody watching us tonight. What is urban farming, rather?
Well, there are many forms of urban farming, but I recommend hydroponics. Hydroponics is soilless farming. In urban dwellings, we don't have space. We don't have farms. People live in story buildings. But still, they need to do agriculture. It can be done everywhere. People can do it on top of their buildings, on the roof of their houses. Small spaces that are available on the sides of their houses, along the perimeter wall, and crops will grow there. Because hydroponics does not use soil. It is soilless farming, farming which does not use soil. It only uses a solution mixed in the water, nutrients that are mixed in the water, which you circulate within the media where you are growing the crop, and the crop nourishes and becomes a good crop, and you'll be able to harvest. Example here, we have lettuce. This is open leaf lettuce.
It looks healthy.
Yeah, it's still young. Yes. It's about 1 week old,
right,
from planting, but it is in good health. So we use cocoa peat or peat moss or any other media that can hold the crop inside this the glass, plastic glass, disposable.
When you say cocoa peat, what is it?
Cocoa peat is a planting material or media which is used in hydroponics. We have many medias. Cocoa peat is just an example.
What is it? What is
in, oh, it is a, it is, it is, okay, a, it is a crushed coconut shell. Mm-hmm. It is crushed and ground into a powder form. We can see an example is there behind you. That is cocoa peat. So that's a media of growing. It is inert. It has no nutrients. You are the one to provide the nutrients. So the work of cocoa peat or peat moss or vermiculite or gravel or whatever you put here, even sand, is just to hold the plant. The nutrients are added by you. You mix them with the solution, with water, then add it in the pipes. Here we are using pipes. But hydroponics can use many other forms. You can use cavera. You can use any container that can hold the nutrient, and then the plant will grow inside there. The advantages of this is that with hydroponics, there's no weeding. It uses very little water, limited water, because the water circulates within the pipes and is again harvested. And it's recycled all over again and harvested. Then recycled all over again and harvested. So you use very limited water. Climate change. This is the medicine for climate change. You don't need rain, you don't need sun, you don't need all this. Whether it's hot, like now, it's cold, it is raining, it is whatever, storms, whatever it is, this crop will always grow, because you grow under a controlled environment. Like you can grow it under shed net or greenhouse or even on the open field. Then, limitation of water usage. Then we are talking of climate change. Then also space. It uses the smallest space available. You can see here the farm is 10 feet by 5 feet only, but I am having 100 plants. That is too much for that space. You can't grow that on soil. You can't. So it uses very limited space, very small space. So that is the advantage of hydroponics. So the crops you grow here for this stand and this system, this style, is for green vegetables. But we have other systems where you can grow fodder for animal feeds, you can grow fruits, you can grow any other type of crop as long as it doesn't grow like a tree. Hydroponics, as long as you keep on supplying the nutrients, always the crops will be growing and will be able to harvest. So my request is, I will love every Kampala people, because there is no space. We don't have space. Those small spaces that they have or on top of their houses, they grow plants using hydroponics. You don't need to go to Nakasero or Wino Market to buy nakate, to buy sukuma wiki, to buy cabbages, to buy lettuce, to buy small things. You grow them in one pipe, two pipes, and that is all. There is no hassle here. There is no weeding. You can spray if you have pest attack, but it's very simple. You just apply the nutrients, and that is all. You wait to harvest. So that is the advantage of the best thing with hydroponics.
So from out of this small space, how much can you harvest? And how much can you have for feeding maybe your own family? Can I also make some money out of it?
Very good, thank you. Okay, I'm using pipes, these 4-inch PVC pipes. This pipe is normally 20 feet. It can have 20 plants, can hold 20 plants of this. 20 plants, that is 20 holes where you'll put the glasses. So one pipe will have 20 holes and 20 plants. Sukuma wiki or spinach or even cabbage. You cannot harvest 20 plants if you have a family of two or three people. You just maybe two or three plants, and you've got enough vegetables.
The rest you can sell.
The rest you can sell to your neighborhood. So this is a source of income for the Kampala people, a source of vegetables for them, food for them. So it makes and reduces the cost of living, because you are utilizing a very small area, very small space, but you are selling at the same time you are consuming at home. Yeah, so it's a very advantageous thing to do for Kampala people, for people living in cities and towns where there is no space. This is very advantageous.
Are there rules when it comes to having this kind of farming within the city? Because I might be renting, I don't have my own space, but I have space rented where I have my home and maybe a compound. Are there rules? Must I get permission from the homeowner or from the city council? What is involved?
I don't think there are any rules. There are no rules, because farming, if you have your rented room, rented house, whatever it is, a condo or whatever, you can even plant your crops along the wall, even on the soil down. Yeah. So if you can do that, still you can use the pipes. There are no conditions. Nobody will. You don't need any certification. This is just farming like any other farming. The difference is that you don't use soil. It's soilless farming, and it makes work easier than growing crops. The space used in this 10 by 5 feet. We are growing 100 crops here, 10 by 5 feet. In soil, you cannot grow that. Maybe you'll grow about 10 crops only. So this is more advantageous. There are no permits or licenses you need. It's just farming, it's just any other. Yes.
Before we go any further, I wanted to know, you said this is from coconut?
Coco pit, yeah, the substance.
How easy is it to get this in Kampala or in Uganda?
Well, it is sold by these crops shops that sell seeds, sell agricultural produce. They also have coco pit or pit moss or vermiculite. All these things are available in Uganda.
Cheaply?
Yeah, it's cheaply. A block of coco pit, I think, is 50,000, which is too much. It's quite enough for you to grow enough crops. Yes. You can also use pit moss. Pit moss is sold by so many shops. Even our neighbors here are selling it. Holland Green Tech, they have it here. They sell it. Yeah, so it is available. All these things are available locally. The nutrients you mix in the water are available.
And where do we get it from? Because you said we have to add the nutrients into the
water.
Yeah, water.
Right? Yeah, you mix with the water.
So where do we get it from?
We supply it. I personally mix it and supply it. I'm an expert in that.
Is there a possibility that I could do the mixing on my own? Like I come to you, you tell me what is involved, maybe at a fee? And then I do the mixing by myself.
Currently we are training. I am training youth the youth and people, or farmers, on how to grow hydroponics. And that training comes together with the mixing of the nutrients. Mm. So it's part of our package. Mm. Yeah.
And when it comes to this, I may call it a garden.
Yeah, it's a garden. It's a farm.
It's a garden.
Yeah.
How easy is it to get this kind of arrangement, and from where, and what is the cost of getting this?
Thank you very much. Mm. These pipes are PVC pipes, 4-inch. They are available in all hardwares. Mm-hmm. Timber is available everywhere. Mm-hmm. Nails, mm-hmm, available everywhere. These caps, disposable, they're in all supermarkets.
Right.
So all these things are locally available. Right. There's nothing complicated here.
Right. But you have a very good arrangement. Is there where I can get this thing already assembled like this, and I just maybe take it to my home at a fee?
There are two ways here. Mm-hmm. We can come to your place and assemble it at your place. All these things can be assembled there. Mm-hmm. Or we can assemble it at our disposal, then we carry it to your place, mm-hmm, whichever.
So how much space again for this?
Space of the unit?
Yeah.
This unit is 5 feet. The width is 5 feet, but the length is 20 feet. These pipes are normally 20 feet. So you can even join the pipes to be 40 feet. You can go and go as long as you want. But going up, it depends on your limitation. The high, the sky is free. You can go, the sky is the limit. Eh? You can go as long, as far, as high as you want. Yeah, you can keep on arranging them.
Okay.
Because mostly we use automated systems where the irrigation is automated. You switch on the pump, pumps the water. We can see here. He's changing. Here we have the pump. This is our pump. We are not using it today because we don't have power.
Okay.
This pump is connected to this pipe. Mm. This is the supply pipe of this water, which supplies in the garden.
Mm.
These other pipes are the drainage pipes that brings it water. I told you there is that recycling. Eh? Mm. The water is recycled throughout. Mm. So the pipes take water with the nutrient into the garden, into the pipes. Then again, the water is harvested by this pipe. The excess water comes back here. So the recycling continues.
Mm.
You are using the pipe. This is automated system.
Mm.
If you don't have the capacity for the automated system, then you can scoop this water with your chidomola and pour it manually in the pipe.
Right.
It's not a must that it is automated. No,
right.
You can do it manually.
Okay.
Yes.
You can use the jerry can.
Yes.
And you pour water.
You pour the water there.
Crops.
Then the water will circulate.
Yeah. But when I see this element of electricity being used, how costly is it for any farmer?
It's a very small pump. Mm. Very, very small. You can use solar. There are solar pumps if you don't want to use electricity, or you can use power. It consumes very little power. But the best thing is that if the garden is small, then you go manual.
Mm.
Forget about this electricity thing.
Mm.
You just pour the water here, it will go and come back, and you harvest it and put it again. Maybe in a week, if it is not very hot, you can circulate it twice or thrice in a week. Yeah.
And the challenges, I believe there are a bit of challenges that
there.
Come
yeah.
with it. Yes.
Challenges are there. Very many, not very many, but challenges are there, of course.
Yes.
Pests.
Yeah.
Pests, and well, of course, these are crops.
Mm.
They can be attacked by pests.
Mm.
So you need to spray.
Mm.
Or you can protect by having a shade net or a greenhouse where it is protected.
Mm.
It's completely protected. Mm. So it is covered. The pests cannot attack.
Mm.
But spraying is the best, whatever medicine you spray, so that you can kill them. The other thing maybe is the cost. Some people will say, oh, this pipe is 30,000. Now I need 10 pipes. That is 300,000. I don't have that kind of money.
Mm.
So cost is also implication. Eh? It's there. The other thing is management. You have to be close on with your crops. Eh? Because you need to manage it close. They always you'll be close to it. So that it needs time also to be close to me, with your crops. Yeah, so in general, although challenges are there, but there are not many. There are
right.
not many as we compare to the soil.
Right.
Here there is no soil.
Okay.
Soil-borne diseases are not, we don't count them here.
Right.
Because they are not there.
Right.
There is no soil here.
Okay.
Yes.
So how often do I need to, because you say the pests are a big challenge. So how often should I spray the vegetables when I discover that they're actually some pests?
Once a week. It's supposed to be protective first before you wait for the pest to attack. So at least once a week is fine. Yeah, spraying, especially sukuma wiki, cabbages, they are really attacked. So, spinach also is really attacked, so you need to spray if you have not protected. But if you have constructed under a shed net, then you don't have to worry. about sprays. Mm. Why? Because it is protected. Pests cannot enter. Mm. You protect with a greenhouse, but greenhouse is expensive, then you can use a shed net. Mm. Yes.
And you talk about the vegetables that perhaps, let's move this side, the vegetables that are highly attacked by the pests, which includes sukuma wiki. Yeah. So which one doesn't get so much attacked? If I wanted to focus on one that doesn't get so much attacks from pests, what should I focus?
Lettuce. Mm. Lettuce.
No wonder it's clean.
Lettuce does not have attacks. It's
right.
Rarely attacked.
Right.
So if you grow lettuce for salads, it is the best. That's why you have got a lot of lettuce.
We are getting some very exciting explanations from Mr. Kioko. And from all that he has explained, we would want to know how much harvest can I get if I'm into urban farming and I have this kind of, arrangement in my home and I want to perhaps engage in commercial sale of the vegetables.
Thank you. The advantage of hydroponics, number one, is usage of space. This unit you are seeing here for our display is only 10 feet by 5 feet. 10 feet long, 5 feet wide. And because we are planting going up, we have planted here 100 plants. When you compare that with the soil, if you were to use that size of land to grow the crops here, maybe we'll grow about 20 spinach plants in that space. You can see the difference. 100 compared to 20 on the soil. So hydroponics utilizes very little space. So space-wise is the advantage of hydroponics. You can't compare hydroponics with the soil. Hydroponics utilizes very small space. This small space with so many crops, you can see the advantage. So you can't compare actually, it's quite much. So the harvest, when you compare the harvest between the soil-based crops, when you plant the same area, and the hydroponics, then you find hydroponics, you are harvesting a lot of crops, a lot of harvest compared to the soil-based planting. Yes, okay. Yes.
So, I wanted to know, is it just forbidden for me to introduce soil into this kind of farming? Because you're talking about the usage of
media. Planting
yes.
medias,
yes.
other medias apart
yes.
from
so
soil.
So if I want to bring the soil, is it acceptable or it's totally forbidden?
When you talk of hydroponics, the other name of hydroponics is soilless farming. Now when we say soilless farming, how do you put soil again?
You talk about the cocopit.
Cocopit
I might
is
want
not soil.
To exchange the cocopit with soil.
You can exchange cocopit with peat moss, with vermiculite, with the gravel, with the sand, whatever you have. But not soil.
Why is soil forbidden?
Because it's not this soilless farming. Soilless farming. It is urban areas where there is no soil.
Does it come with germs, perhaps? That's why you don't want
that
it?
That is one of the areas. Actually, soil comes with soil-based diseases, soil-based pests. You have to treat the soil. And again, we say soilless because we are providing the nutrients for the crop. We are providing all the nutrients. We don't need the soil. The soil has got its own nutrients, but we don't need them here. Here we have our nutrients for hydroponics that are completely enough. So totally with hydroponics, soil is not there. It's like having a boy and a girl. The boy cannot be a girl and the girl cannot be a boy. Yes.
But you know you can farm in soil and not even fertilize or anything and your crops will grow, but here you'll need nutrients. Yeah, so that still brings me back to the soil element.
With the soil, I agree. With the soil, soil is like a bank account. Wherever you grow crops and harvest, it's like going to the bank account and withdrawing money without depositing. In the soil, at some time, it will have no nutrients. You'll have to apply what? Fertilizers. Same as this. So instead of using soil,
you just start with the nutrients away.
You apply the nutrients all over.
Which is not costly.
No, they're not costly. They're not costly and they're available. They're not costly. They're available and they're special.
My other question would be, this is a very good setup. I might want it for my home, which is small, but I could also be a farmer and I have this large piece of land and I want to just do this kind of farming. Is it possible for me to get several of this and farm?
Very much. You can have as big size as you want. And we do all that. We do the setting. Our company, Capsicum Valley Products, does all that. The setting up of a hydroponics unit is our work, is our specialty. So we can set up it and you'll be harvesting. And you'll be doubling, even more than doubling, the harvest you get in the soil. Yes.
So what is the biggest space you can manage to put this kind of setup for hydroponics?
The limit is there's no limit. your capacity is the limit. Yeah, capacity in terms of funds, capacity in terms of space is the limit. But there's no limit in farming. Mm. Farming can grow even 1,000 acres, whatever you want. Mm. There's no limit. The best thing is that, why do we say urban farming? It's because in urban areas, we don't have enough land. We have plots. So we utilize that small plot, that small space to grow crops. That is the idea. So if you have 100 acres, 200 acres, why should you go to hydroponics? It is for those people with small spaces, but they still want to have their own crops at home.
You might want to adventure.
Fine, it is acceptable. There's no limit. It's just farming like any other. And you see, you can have what you call a cocktail farming in hydroponics, where you have each pipe having a different crop. Sukuma wiki here, spinach here, nakate here, cabbages here, strawberries there. So the family will have all sorts of vegetables and fruits at their disposal. Mm. Yeah.
And do I need labor for this? If I had this space,
yeah.
Do I need support?
Yeah, you need the construction. Once you have it, you don't need support. Once it's done. But construction, you need us to construct for you, to bring the timber, the pipes, the setting up, the training, the nutrients, and all that. After that, it will be now you to run it.
But you talked about the watering.
Yes.
I might be working and I have to go very early to work. Then I might have some people who want to buy some of my vegetables. So really, don't I need some sort of support, some sort of labor to come and help me with my...
This media inside here is supposed to hold water. Mm-hmm. It is water. It absorbs a lot of water. So when the nutrients are applied here, they are absorbed by this, and it can take even 2 to 3 days, unless it is very hot. Take 2 to 3 days before it dries. Mm. So in a week, you might find that you are irrigating only twice. Mm. You are applying the water twice or three times in a week. So it's not labor intensive. That is one of the advantages of hydroponics. Mm. It's not labor intensive. There is no weeding here. Mm. You just make sure the nutrients have passed, they recycle back to their source, and that is all. Very simple. That's why you say smart farming for people who are smart. You don't get dirty when you have hydroponics. Mm. You remain clean and smart.
Yeah, so what is your final message for people who have small space in their homes and they are struggling to feed themselves and perhaps make money, or they want to innovate and do some sort of agriculture?
Thank you. Kampala people, city dwellers, all cities and towns in Uganda, this is the way to go. You don't have to go to the markets, Nakasero, to buy nakati. You don't have to go to the markets to buy sukuma wiki. When you have a small space at your disposal in your farm, please, Kampala people, we are in Kampala here, grow your own vegetables at your own small space at your disposal, at your residence, where you stay. I can set up this for you, and you'll be able to grow as much as you want, depending on the space. So you don't have to buy vegetables while you can do them without using soil. At your disposal, small space. Yes, please. That's what I request. All city dwellers, please, let's go into hydroponics. That is the only way you have food security.
So one final question for you is a breakdown of what every urban dweller or urban farmer may need in order to have to successfully, you know, engage in urban farming, especially hydroponics. What do they need?
To venture into hydroponics, you need a small space. You have any space that you have is available at your disposal, at your residence. One. Two, you buy these materials. The pipes are in hardwares. The timber is available in hardwares. The nails and a carpenter. Then skill which I dispose, which I provide, and the nutrients which I also provide, and that is all.
Well, you have heard it from the expert, Godfrey Kiyoko. When it comes to food security, it is very important that you innovate and find ways actually to get food onto your table. And it is very easy. He says all you have to do is hydroponics. It's this as you've seen, this setup is on a 10 by 5, 10 feet, 5, the width is 5. So it's very small and it can give you a lot of vegetables that can provide food security in your home and also bring you plenty of finances. You don't have to cry that you don't have this big piece of land where you can farm and get food to your table or get money. Get innovative, embrace urban farming, and all will be well in your family and in your finances. I've been your host on Harvest Money Show tonight, Jackie Achan. Until next time, goodbye.